So there is a cave that we went into a couple of weeks ago that had a really interesting pool of water in it that had some what is some microbiologists are calling blue goo. So they've asked us to go back into the cave today and take some samples of it for them. So we're going to go do a little bit of cave science for some microbiologists, get some samples of this blue stuff that's in this cave so they can test it and see what it is. So come along, let's go check it out. Y'all are going to get to see some really cool stuff today, some cave science here in Alabama. So for those of you who don't know, I have actually been caving for 20 years in this region. I've been doing it since my mid-20s. There's over 11,000 caves in just Tennessee alone. So there's so many caves here, so many things to do, so many cool things. There's a lot of science in caving that a lot of people don't get to see. So we're going to show you that today. We're going to show you some cave science. I've learned a lot over the years from microbiologists, biologists, hydrologists, geologists. So I'm kind of what you call a citizen scientist. So let's go check it out. All right, so we're back at this cave, and we're going to go in, and we're going to take some samples. So we are here in the cave where this blue stuff is located, and I'm going to be very careful here not to step in the water because we're going to get ready to take some samples of this for the microbiologists that are studying this blue stuff that occurs in caves. So here is what we're supposed to get, some DNA swabs, as well as if we can get any of the blue globs in the water, and then some samples of the sediment as well. So we'll just start pulling out. This is extra. Mm-hmm. And then I've got a bag for each one of these samples. And then we've got gloves as well. So I've got them all rolled up. Let's see, what else do we have in here? Some gloves. Extra bag, some Sharpies, and a field notebook. Okay, so we're just getting ready to start taking our samples here. And we'll go over here, and you'll probably, Dylan, you're going to have to probably stand right here.
Okay.
And then she'll kind of go around and walk in from the back side over there. You and I, Dylan, we want to stay out of the water.
You're saying go in from...
Right. Like where you'll disturb it the least amount as far as sediment as you're walking. So just walk really slowly and carefully across the rocks. Try not to stir anything up. All right. And so you'll just want to go over there where you can get an arm's reach of her. My light up, and then we'll start with the rings, the dark patch, the lighter ring, and then the lightest ring.
Okay. I think you're gonna have to...
Yeah, you'll have to open it all for her. Yeah, she should be able to open that, and then we'll just gather all the trash in one spot, and then we'll put all the trash in one bag at the end.
Okay. So the first one that I'm doing is the,
dark spot. Oh, and I need to give you a Sharpie. We need to do a Sharpie too, Dylan. We got to label these. Let me get over a little closer to you. So as she comes out, actually, we're probably going to want to go ahead and label that one A. So that's the dark patch. No, straight in front of you, 12 o'clock in front of you, a little closer, a little, You're not going, yeah, right, like maybe a foot to your left. That dark, come down a couple of inches in that dark area right there. Yep. You want to swab that dark area on the ground. So in front of it, see how it's lighter?
Yeah.
So we're gonna do three swabs here. One of the darkest area.
Right here. One of the darkest.
Yes, yep. And then the lighter and then the lightest.
Okay, okay.
Yep. Yeah, so this one's gonna be A.
So the darkest. So I'm just sticking it down in here and like
swabbing that area.
Okay.
Swabbing it for science. And then put that in the thing, and then you'll have to, there you go.
How long is not enough?
Not enough that I broke it off.
No.
Oh, got to break a little bit more.
And then the lighter.
Pull down. Four more swabs to go. So, yeah, go about
like in this little crease.
A little bit further out from it.
Oh.
Where the color changes.
Yeah.
Get a sample. Yep, perfect. I guess they're trying to see if it's different bacterias.
Like closer or further away from the... Okay. And then I need some more...
Okay. The next one will be C, what's called the white ring. Just a little bit further out from that. Yep. D is going to be a couple feet in front of your right foot in the dark blue, the darkest blue area.
Okay. I'm going to go like right here.
Yep.
Okay.
And now next... So that's all the swabs, A, B, C, D. Oh, we got an E. Did we do E?
We did not do E.
E, let's see. E, okay, E's on the other side. We'll come back for E when you can walk over there. So I'm going to go get the other tubes, and we'll do the others over here. E, D, it's a different tube, so it's okay to have the same number on it. It's going to be the dark blue globs in water. So he wants an actual sample. So we're done with the swabs.
Okay. So this is.
So yeah, let's go with some sediment and a little bit of water for this one in that that area.
In this red one.
Yeah.
Okay.
And this is Delta.
Yeah. And then we'll just get, yeah, set some, and you can just, I guess, just use your hands to maybe pick it up. If you see anything that looks like gelatinous, which I don't, but.
Should I get more like actual?
Yeah, I would actually get a piece of the sediment in there as well.
There's some good particles in there. I'd like to get more in there.
I think that would be okay.
Okay.
Okay, so now he also wanted a dark blue globs frozen, but I don't think there's any of that in this. I don't think there's anything like that in this pool of water.
Mm-hmm.
So I would come back out now, and then we'll have you walk around the other side, and we'll get that sample from the other side. He wants a swab of the white area. Oh, wait, I did forget. He did want... Is there any sediment in the dark area right there? I don't really... very first swab?
Yeah.
He did want sediment and water from A as well. So we're going to have to use another small tube from A and write S-E... Actually... Yeah, just write S-E-D on it for sediment. And we don't need a swab for this one. Mm-hmm. My bad. It's the one across the way that we need the swab for. Yeah, this one's just sediment and water from that same area where we first swabbed. Okay. Yeah, and it'll settle down too.
Enough that he can like centrifuge it down or something. I'm getting a swab and sediment.
This one is.
Sorry.
That's okay. This is just a swab.
Okay.
Is all we need of that. Yep, just a swab.
What is the label going to be?
This one is going to be E. Yep, just in that area right there. All right, and then that is our last sample. Taking some notes of what we did here. We're just noting that the sediment or the blue stuff is here in the stream. There's no flowing water. However, there is dripping water from above. Okay, so we've taken some notes here of what we've done and what we've collected, also describing the cave passage. We're going to get all of our samples here packed up, take them home, and get them sent off to the laboratory to the microbiologist. Got all of our samples packed up. Gonna go out of the cave. So now that the samples are collected, I'm gonna see if we can get some video footage here of this blue stuff in the So there is a Tennessee cave salamander right here. Under those little rocks.
Please.
Yeah, just so we can get a better view of him.
Oh shit, what an asshole.
Oh, he's gonna hide. Yeah. Pretty cool little creature. You can see they have gills right there on the back of their hid.
So now we're going to pack up our samples that we collected in the cave and get them sent off back to the university for the microbiologist to study.